Okay, so let's proceed with our second video. So put the adjective adverbs in brackets into the correct form, adding any necessary words, and necessary words may be than, the, we will see on the way. So the more he read about the mystery of Atlantis, the more fascinating he found it. Thanks to the advances in technology, space shuttles are becoming what? Faster and faster. So the type of comparative, do you remember? Comparative degree and comparative degree. Patrick isn't interested in visiting ancient ruins, the least interested, not only little interested, but the least interested, we mean that he is not at all. Alice's project on space exploration wasn't as well presented as her teacher would have liked. This is one word that we add, or the Roswell UFO crash was by far the most publicized UFO story in the last century. They walked, okay, so the farther they walked into the cave, the darker it became. Okay, so another type of comparison. It is believed that the Inca civilization was far more advanced than the European civilization at that time. So here we are going to use comparative degree. The article I read about Arkheim was less informative than I had expected. Again, here we ask for comparative degree. Stories about the Loch Ness Monster go back as far as the 1930s. So here we can understand that we are going to use this type of comparison because we have S here. Okay, you can always refer to the slides that I'm representing you now. Okay. Okay, so let's proceed with the fifth exercise. Read the text and use adjectives from the list below to compare the places, to compare them. Okay, you may use comparative superlative degree and also the types of comparison. So please stop the recording, do the exercise. Let's check it together now. Okay, for example.
The Great Pyramid and Stonehenge are older than the Nazca lines.
Okay.
Easter Island is the most remote of all the places. Stonehenge is large, but the Great Pyramid is the largest structure. All the structures are puzzling, but the mystery of the Nazca lines is the most puzzling of all. I think the Moai are more magnificent than Stonehenge. The Moai are very impressive, but the Great Pyramid is the most impressive structure of all. The Great Pyramid covers a vast area, but the Nazca lines cover the vastest area.
Okay, cover the vastest area. Okay, so here it is from the mysterious places from our reading section. Okay, so read the joke, look at the underlined phrases. How do we form inversions? So here we came into our second part. We are going to talk about inversion. But what is an inversion, first of all? Inversion. This happens after certain expressions when they are placed at the beginning of a sentence. So we are used to them, to seeing them into the middle or at the end of the sentence. Inversion, it means that these certain expressions are placed at the beginning of the sentence. Why? In order to give emphasis on the sentence that we are talking about. These, some of these expressions are these: barely, hardly ever when, in no way, in, under no circumstances, little, never before, nor neither, or neither, you can pronounce it as you like, no sooner than, not even once, not only but also, not till until, nowhere, only by, only in this way, on no account, on no occasion, only the, rarely, scarcely ever when, and seldom. Okay, so this is inversion. We can invert the subject and the auxiliary verb in the sentence to give emphasis. If there is no auxiliary verb, we use do, does for the present simple or did for the past simple in the interrogative. So even in the interrogative, we can use do, does or did. It may show to you that how can this happen, but yes, it can happen. For example,
the Great Wall of China is not only one of the great wonders of the world, but it is also a very popular tourist destination.
Is not only, but it is also. Okay, and now look how we can make it inversion. Okay, so in order to emphasize it more, we have got used to this way. Look inversion.
Not only is the Great Wall of China one of the great wonders of the world, but it is also a very popular tourist destination.
This is the inversion. Okay, when a sentence begins with only after, only by, only if, only when, not since, not till, until, we invert the subject and the auxiliary verb in the main clause. We invert it. What do we mean? That we use it as it is into its question. We put did or do or does, for example.
Only after we had visited Machu Picchu in Peru did we understand how mysterious a place it is.
Not only we understand, but did we understand in order to emphasize it more. This is called inversion. Okay? Inversion also happens in conditionals when should and where, type 1 and type 2, and had, type 3, are replaced at the beginning of the sentence. It means that if is omitted. For example,
if they had been outside, they would have seen the lunar eclipse. Had they been outside, they would have seen the lunar eclipse.
And please note that this is a question that they put it not always, but most of the times in the exams, okay, inversion, in order to see that. Do you know how we form the third conditional? And do we know that it is applicable this way when we refer to inversion, okay? So, also happens to such a degree, placed at the beginning of a sentence, for example.
The Bermuda Triangle is so mysterious that many disappearances of ships and planes have remained unsolved.
So, in order to emphasize it more, we don't put it here into the middle of the sentence as we are used to it up to now, but
so mysterious is the Bermuda Triangle that many disappearances of ships and planes have remained unsolved.
Okay. Finally, inversion happens after so, when used to agree with an affirmative sentence, neither nor, when used to agree with a negative statement and as to express agreement, for example.
My grandparents believe that the Loch Ness Monster exists, and so do my parents. However, I don't, and nor does my friend.
So, and so do my parents. Okay, you could only say, my parents believe it, or, okay. And so do my parents. Okay, however, I don't, and nor does my friend, again here, nor, okay, in order to agree with a negative statement, and nor does my friend. Okay, let's proceed with some exercises in order to see. So, read the joke, look at the underlying phrases, how do we form inversion, okay?
Not only have I been into space several times, but I have also walked on the moon.
It's my first trip into space. I'm pretty nervous. Can you give me some advice?
Yes, don't look down.
Yes, don't look down. So not only look here, the inversion. So what are inversions? Inversions are formed by changing the word order in a sentence. We change it because we put here into the beginning in order to show our emphasis. Usually to emphasize the verb or the subject, sorry, or the verb of the sentence. Okay, here we emphasize the verb, okay? At other sentences, we may emphasize even the subject, okay? So such a shock did he have that he never recovered. It means he had such a big shock that he never recovered. I don't believe in aliens, neither do I, to agree, okay? I love astrology, so do I. You could also say, me too. Seldom do we see a solar eclipse. We seldom see it. It should be the correct, let's say, word order. Okay, but in order to emphasize it more, we put the adverb of frequency first. Should you be awake? We will watch the meteor shower. First conditional. If you're awake, we will watch the meteor shower. So we put it here in order to emphasize it more. So we are ready to continue with exercise 6. Read the examples, then reread the sentences as inversions. So the sun had just set when we saw the first shooting star. So hardly had the sun set when we saw the shooting star. Hardly had the sun set. Had, okay? The sun set. So here it is a kind of question, okay? So different word order. He was so amazed by the sight of the Great Pyramid that he couldn't speak. So amazed was he by the sight of the Great Pyramid that he couldn't speak. Was he? So again, inversion, it means that we change the word order in a sentence. And here from an affirmative, it is done into a question sentence. If she had studied history, third conditional, she would have known, he would have known about the Aztecs. Had he studied history, she would have known about the Aztecs. We seldom see Saturn and Mercury in the sky together. Seldom do we see Saturn and Mercury in the sky together. So here, not only that we put seldom here, but we turn this sentence, okay? We transform this sentence from affirmative into a question. He's an astronaut as well, a university professor. Not only is he an astronaut, but he's a university professor as well. So first of all, in order to form inversion, we put some words and phrases, as we said here, at the beginning of the sentence, the first thing. The second thing is that we change the word order of the sentence that is given in order to form the inversion. And from an affirmative sentence, here it is transformed into a question sentence. Be careful, here it is a full stop, not question, because it is an inversion. Okay, so this is part two.